Brady, Neil and Darren have done another slightly strange experiment. They decided to cool balloons down, balloons containing hydrogen, with liquid nitrogen. And of course, when you cool a gas, it contracts and the balloon follows down. But of course, as the balloon gets smaller, its weight doesn't change, it displaces less air, and it can't float. And as you warm it up again, it starts expanding, displaces more air, and eventually rises up. And when it started rising up, of course, they couldn't resist putting a match to it. But the strange thing to them was when they put a match to this cold balloon, it didn't make as loud a bang as it did when they used a warm balloon. When you look at the actual footage, there isn't all that much difference between the flames that you see. But the camera doesn't have as sensitive ears as my colleagues. But the people in the room definitely noticed a difference. So what was going on? Well, the obvious explanation is, first of all, that when the balloon is cold, the rubber is not as stretchy. So when you light it, it won't fly away as quickly. And secondly, that the gas is at a lower pressure because it's colder. So what this means is that the balloon will burst more slowly and the gas won't expand as fast. It won't mix with air so quickly with oxygen, and therefore you'll get the same amount of heat, but it'll be released more slowly. So you won't get the big shock wave that makes you go whoo! The big question is, how could you test this? We thought that perhaps you could test it by putting the hydrogen, instead of in a balloon, in a plastic bag, because a plastic bag will inflate, but it's not under tension like a balloon, so it will burst much more slowly. So the gas was not really under pressure at all. After a quick try with a sandwich bag, taken from one of my students, she had to have her lunch early. We then tried with a white plastic bag, which was tied loosely, but not really sealed. And when you put the match to it, there was something which we all thought looked a bit like the Hindenburg airship crashing. The bag caught fire. There was a small fireball, but no explosion in the same way. Which suggests that the idea of the rubber being stretched and the fact that the gas was lower pressure might explain the absence of the explosion. But we haven't really demonstrated that the oxygen is also needed. So we started with a second bag, this time green. And the green bag was filled with hydrogen, but the bottom was left completely open, so that the air could go in and mix with the hydrogen. So we had a sort of mixture of hydrogen and oxygen, much better to burn. And when we lit that one, there was a much more convincing pop, but still the bag caught fire and just burnt.
Yeah, all good.
So it would appear that this rather strange experiment with a balloon and liquid nitrogen was a combination of two effects. The balloon didn't burst so quickly, and the hydrogen didn't mix with the air as well because its pressure was lower. But what was quite interesting is that rather than the balloon, where little bits disappear across the room and you rarely find them, we ended up with two quite artistic pieces of burnt plastic, and they're quite hard. it makes quite a bang. I'm sure you've all been at children's parties where the little children burst into tears when the balloon bursts because of the noise.